So in this activity, we have taken one battery eliminator to note down the current 1 milliammeter and two connecting wires, and we have given a gap here. In this gap, now we are going to connect two different kinds of bulbs and one specific resistance wire. So now we will see what are the readings, the corresponding readings that are obtained in the milliammeter. So now first let us connect. Now you can see the bulb glows with very low intensity, and here the milliammeter is showing around 90 milliamperes. So now let us fill this gap with this bulb. Now you can see the bulb is glown, and the reading that is obtained in milliammeter is around 210. Now let us fill this gap by a wire. Now we see that the reading in the milliammeter is around 250 milliamperes. So what actually we wanted to show from this activity, the same is the potential difference, it is always connected at 2 volts only, rest of the things are same, only we are filling this gap with two different bulbs and a separate wire. Now for each component we are getting different readings. So why actually we are getting that different readings? It is just because of the resistance offered by the three components. In the case of this wire, the milliammeter is showing 250 milliamperes, and when compared to the two other bulbs, it is more. Therefore, we can conclude that this is allowing more current through it. In the case of this bulb, it is 200 milliamperes. Therefore, it offers somewhat less current than this wire is passing through this bulb. And in the very first bulb, it was 90 milliamperes only.